Alrighty, so I got a camera working. Alright, I'm gonna try to help you here with how to do juuling. I'm not a YouTuber, so I don't know really how to do this. I'm just gonna go ahead and go with it. So for this dude, I'm gonna do a green juuling on the canopy. So green on the canopy, I'm gonna try to paint. I have a really small area to paint because this phone is sitting on the stand that you see there on the right. So it's not gonna be very easy. Do my best to paint around it. So I gotta get my hand around the camera. We're gonna do it and it's gonna fucking work. So we're gonna make it fucking work. Bright for me, bright enough that I can see what I'm doing, but too bright for the camera that the camera can't see what the fuck I'm doing. So maybe if I do this, I'll see. Oh, wait a minute. There we go. There we go. All right. There we go. That is pretty. Okay. Fuck you. So this is gonna be interesting. Because I've never done this before, but I do need both my hands. And it's a lot darker now, so I can't see. Alright, fuck it. We're gonna do it. So, first I'm gonna go dark to light. As you can see, I haven't painted anything on here. This is just the contrast blood, corn blood, like the darker red, and that's gonna be just the main spot. But to get the good base for the canopy, we're gonna want something that's dark, but not too dark. And so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put some heavy charcoal, which is like a really dark blue gray. And what that's gonna do is it's gonna establish a good base that isn't black, completely black, but will be dark enough for us to do the base coat of green and have something to paint over. And so this is kind of like painting in reverse what you're used to, because you know you're used to doing like a white base and then you put like a wash over it, and then the wash or the glaze will cover the white and give it that color that you want and sort of fade it a little, like from one point to another, where it looks like a faux jeweling, you know? Like that's the jeweling that you got with that purple canopy on the Griffin, which isn't bad. I mean, that's one way to do it. I had to switch out my brush because the one I was using doesn't have a good tip, and it's one of my workhorse brushes. Right now I'm using one of those Kalinske Sable brushes, so that one's gonna do me a little better. So I keep getting out of frame. I don't want to keep getting out of frame if I don't have to. So now what we're gonna do, now that the Now that the heavy charcoal's on there, we're going to let it dry for a little bit. It's really hard right now because I don't have enough lighting to show you the color properly, so I'm gonna have to tilt this thing. And the position of the camera is not conducive to this, but again, first time, and we're gonna try our best here. Alright, so the next thing I wanna do is I wanna go with a dark green. I'm gonna use this Game Color Opaque heavy black green. So again, it's essentially like Angel Green from Army Painter. And it's a dark green. So now usually when you do any kind of canopy work, you want the brightest color to be in the bottom, either the bottom left or the bottom right. And so you want to start off in like that L shape, and you're not going to notice it because it's so dark, but once you build it up enough, you'll notice it, and that's what's going to give you that jeweling effect. But what you're trying to do is you're trying to have a starting point of the light. And I keep lifting it out of fucking focus. Alright, so there we go. Now you can see what I'm doing. It's left side, but my right side. Alright, so that's it for that. I'm gonna do more, but I don't have to do more right now. So I'm looking at that. I'm looking at seeing, you know, where the green is. And I know it's really hard to see because of the shitty lighting. Shape here, and after this like third-ish layer you start seeing the green a little bit better. And it doesn't have to be perfect, it doesn't have to be hyper perfect, you just want something to break the dark gray, the heavy charcoal, or the black, or whatever you use as your main color. So you know what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna move that light so that it's actually facing the model, and we're gonna see if the camera can pick it up better like this. But now the problem is my hand won't be able to touch it, but we're not gonna care right now because this is all experimental. It was better when the damn light was above. You know what, let me check this off. Okay, this is the problem with lighting and cameras and all this other shit. When you don't have sufficient lighting, you can't see what you're doing, and when you can't see what you're doing, you're gonna fuck up, and when you fuck up, it's gonna look like shit, and when it looks like shit, people aren't gonna like what you did. So, but yeah, so the camera is showing the room darker than it actually is. It's a lot brighter in person, so I mean, I can see what I'm doing, but you really can't see what I'm doing because of the lighting. But you can kind of see the difference between the heavy charcoal up here and the dark green that's right there. And now what we're gonna do is, this is where I could take some white and then mix it with that dark green to get like a lighter green. I can just do the transition over and over again if I really wanted to go crazy and do like a crazy ass, you know, transition of color, but I'm not gonna do that. What I'm gonna do is I'm going to skip that and go straight into my really bright green color. So this will help twofold. What this is gonna do is this is going to give you that contrast, so you know where to work up to, and it's going to cut on the little tutorial time. So what I'm going to use right now is I have a couple greens to choose from. I think I'm going to go with a Scorpena green, which is like a light green, kind of a lime, like a lime green. It's a Vallejo game color green, and it's already kind of thin, which I have no idea if that's because it's old or because it's a shitty paint or because of whatever. But what I'm gonna do is, unlike the last time where we did the whole canopy L shape, I'm just gonna pick out the very, very bottom corner of where I want that light green to be at. So I'm gonna start with just that little point in the bottom right. And again, don't worry if you fuck up a little bit, because as you go, you'll feel out how much of that green you want there. How much of that green you actually want there to be there on that spot. And you have to just think about not overwhelming it. So right there I feel like I overdid it a little bit. But that's okay. Get a little L. My thumb was in the way. So right there, I got a little L, like a little L shape green. And then right there I got like a little jab, you know, like I just jabbed it. Okay, and then right here on this right side, my right side, you know. And then over here on kind of the bottom corner. And see, now what you notice is I kind of fucked up, right? I kind of went too far and I made a blob instead of a nice clean line. So guess what I'm going to do now? Watch this. You take some of that old dark green that you had before, and then you go there, and look at that. You didn't fuck it up anymore. See, it's nice and sharp. It's nice and sharp. See that? See how sharp that little line is now? That little green line? A little too sharp. So I'll have to come back and probably paint over it again. And then again, tracing that L shape that we're used to doing already. So where that bright green jab was, it's not a jab anymore. Now it's a perfectly clean little, what looks like a little line now. You can kind of see it, you know? And on this side, it's already kind of good, so I don't even have to go over it with the dark green. But essentially, now we go back to that bright green. And what I'm going to do is take a little water. I'm going to thin it up a little. I'm going to thin it up, make it thin. Make it a little thinner. So it's so thin that you can barely see it. And then I'm going to go back over it on the other side. And it's a back and forth, back and forth. You're just going back and forth, back and forth. Forth, back and forth. You see, now you can kind of start seeing what I'm talking about. You see, you have the really bright green on the very tip of the corner, and then you have kind of a fading dark green on the outer side. See? So, heavy charcoal, dark green, that sort of faded light green, and the bright green. And so you already have about three colors in there. And I mean, you can leave it at that. You're pretty much done if you want to be done, but I'm not done. So, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go for my favorite little color here, the ivory white, because ivory white is like a yellowish white, you know, it's like a bone white, you know. But what we're gonna do is we're gonna put that little bit of that on the very, very, very tip of that corner, okay? So, very, 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 very tip. So, right there. Oop, too far. Okay, too much. Lick my brush and wipe before it dries. Wipe, 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 wipe. Wipe away. And you know what? If it doesn't wipe, it's fine. Because we still have that glazy green, or this will take it to the leftmost part of that white, the leftmost part. And now it's almost like, you know, like there's a, whatchamacallit, like there's a glare, you know, of some bright light on that side. See? We're gonna take some more of that white, and then we're gonna match the position of that bright kind of glare, just a little spot, you know, so it matches with where that light brightness is, just right there, you know. And instead of going up, I'm just gonna go down with it. I'm just gonna go down, and then keeping my brush moist. I don't want my brush to. This is one of those, whatchamacallums. There's a Raphael, really, really nice ones. For this, you really want a nice brush. You don't want to be using some cheapy brush that can't hold a tip, because you're going to be really trying to get control, as much control as possible with your brush here. You don't want to lose control, especially when you're working with something this small, because if you lose control now, you potentially have the chance of either over painting it and or just it not turning out the way you want. I'm not forgetting that I'm still going back and forth here. Still back and forth. You don't want to forget are still trying to keep this up, back, and forth. This is not something that is a one swipe and you're done. So what I did there was a feathering technique. So it was kind of a mini wet blend. So what I did was I overshot with the white, so then I overshot with the bright green, and then I overshot with the darker green. But because it was all still wet, I blended it together. And now I have a really cool, almost a bright green to dark fade, you know? But now I want more of the bright green. And so this is where you could choose to mix, you know, your dark green with your bright green to get an intermediate color. And that intermediate color will be the one that blends both the bright and the dark green together, you know. And I mean, I was kind of skipping that, you know, to show you that you don't really have to. But you know, you can, and it can still look good. There. You can see that I'm trying to kind of keep it bright towards the bottom, and I want to keep it dark towards the top. So, as you're seeing, I'm going back and forth with it. I'm not just stopping once I got one coat on it. I'm still going with it. I'm still touching it. I'm still expecting to have to go back. I'm not quitting. I got the goal in mind. I got the idea of what I want it to look like. And I want to keep dabbing it. I can dab it. I can brush it. You can sort of like you're stippling. You can stipple it. You can feather it. However you feel is more comfortable for you. You know? However you feel. But see that ivory now is doing its thing. It's shining, you know, underneath the bright green, and the bright green is fading into the dark green. Now, I want contrast. Now, I'm gonna pull out the black. And here's where the fucking magic happens right here. Now, remember, I haven't used any glazes, I haven't used any contrast paints or washes. This is all paint, all regular paint. No specialty paint, no Citadel, technical color, nothing. This is all just fucking Vallejo shit you can get at a goddamn Hobby Lobby shit right here. So, for this, now for the black, you want it in the exact opposite side that you were doing your brightest part. And you kind of want to make it dramatic. You see that shit now? So you got like a little tiny bit of the heavy charcoal, that first part you started with, but you got the dark green, the bright green, the ivory, and blends that go from dark to bright. You see? That's what you want. That is what you want. You want it to have all that all that contrast. And don't be afraid if you make like a little circular shape of black on the top, because essentially the canopy is just this black, this clear glass, right? Or at least it has the illusion of a clear glass. And so it's not reflecting anything, it's just see-through. So now you're trying to get it black to imitate that it's see-through and that there's you're looking in, literally looking like you're looking inside the mech. You're looking inside. So now I'm gonna wait for that to dry. And I'm gonna put this thing into something with a little better lighting. My little light box up here. And then we're gonna take a look at it with the camera. And now you can see kind of a little bit better now. You can see what I was trying to do. You see? From kind of a regular vantage point, like you see a pretty good little canopy blend and little canopy chewing. So it's not too bad. Again, it's kind of difficult to do, but I'm not redoing that. I'm gonna keep that. That looks good. Looks really good to me. So, to brighten up the contrast even more, I'm gonna use some cold white. The cold white is definitely a little bit more brighter than the ivory. It's literally like I think the brightest white that there is. So I'm gonna put a little teeny teeny tiny little teeny tiny. Here it's gonna go kind of in the middle top. Gonna go at the really, really deep, and then on this side, it's gonna go kind of in the bottom-ish, middle-ish, right-ish. There we go. And then we need that little iconic dot that sort of goes in the center. Of the black, the center of the black. That's what you want, because that's the little dot of the little shine, that always goes in the corner. Ignore the phone, it's telemarketer bullshit. I never answer those fuckers. Alright, so now you got a jeweled canopy. That's pretty much it. That's all you gotta do. And it's done. And I think it looks great. I think it looks about as good as you can a locust canopy. It's fucking tiny. Oh, come on. Focus, motherfucker. There you go. And then all that's left to do is a gloss varnish on the canopy. And that'll be it. Alright. Thank you.